Yeah, true, true, true. It was like, oh, I lost my first, I lost stock first, and then I lost. Oh, wow. Now we're going into Utopian Rate and My Boy Are Hungry.
Uh-oh.
NJPR versus New York PR.
All right.
And
all right, you got Are Hungry. I got Ray.
Okay, great. Hungry, basically a Zelda main. He has a few side characters. But he actually likes this matchup for Zelda. And early on, he was saying, before people even knew Zelda was good, he was saying, like, Zelda's pretty decent against Palutena specifically.
For real?
So that's, you know, his opinion. He's done pretty good against the character. So we'll see how it goes.
Oh, yeah. We'll see this open up. I feel like, so Ray has, like, two ways of playing. And it might be synonymous to on and off tilt.
Right. But, is the tilt switch on, yes or no?
When he's hitting you, he's like really hitting you, and it's hard to get him to stop.
Right.
But when you're hitting him, you're really hitting him, and it's hard to fail.
Right. Yeah, no, his advantage state is amazing, but then rivaled by his disadvantage
state.
And you know what's funny, actually? That's what a lot of people say about R Hungry, too, actually. R Hungry is like a player where an advantage is amazing, but there are times where he just gets zero to death by, like, people, and you're just like, how did that happen?
Mm. And I feel like that coincides with Zelda's gameplay.
Oh, boy.
Jesus.
And Palutena loving teleport recoveries, man.
Yeah.
Because her down air is active enough to just intercept that. That was a great play by Ray. Also, just Hungry staying on the ledge too long there and getting down tilted in the first place.
Yeah. There's good air dodge and the punish. He said I could do both.
Okay, Hungry being smart there, not spot dodging again and just choosing an offensive option. Zelda's jab is really fast, and it's a good, like, it stuffs people out. So that won him that interaction, even though he did do a panic spot dodge for a second there.
Just there, we just saw, like, a scramble. Ray was, like, on both sides of him, and he was trying to get a hard punch.
Oh, my God. Ray is on fire, bro.
Ray,
he is
please,
prepared for this matchup.
Please, let me commentate.
Yeah. Give me a chance to finish my sentence, Ray.
He just goes for... Okay, the flames are out, the nairs are out.
Oh, man, and this is looking really rough right now.
It's what we were talking. Oh!
And you got Falcon
Yo!
Knee, baby. The one of the most annoying things about Zelda.
Oh my God!
Ray going for some.
What's wrong with him?
Ray wanted that down air three, bro. He wanted that third spike. He wanted to send him back to Jersey right now, bro.
His field goal percentage definitely taking a hit after that one.
Yo, Ray was definitely fishing for that. That was hilarious. He had invincibility. He was like, fuck it.
Dude, Art Hungry is doing that thing. He's, like, finding his footing. What? Dude. What's that thing called? The Shadow Knight?
Yeah, the Phantom.
It just bodied the explosive flame.
Yeah.
It just stood there.
It's really, really good. Your job,
be damned.
Your job is to stand close enough to Zelda where she cannot take, doesn't have enough time to take it out fully charged.
Yeah.
And Palutena obviously has the tools to do that.
Oh my God!
Oh, that
was so close to shield poking.
I cannot believe that did not poke. That was in her head.
It was.
Yikes! Let's see if he gets spiked again. Oh, Ray going for it but missing it. And
Ray is now at 50%.
Getting that knee.
He is now at 50%.
Let's go.
Not in game, but
and Hungry's not out of this, bro. You spiked me. I just need you in the face.
That's what we were talking about. It's like once they get a hit.
You're right. These players are both the same player, man. This is hilarious. Yeah, this is really funny.
Oh my God.
Oh,
oh
man,
nice.
That was a really bad F tilt there.
Really smart space back air, though.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, he was kind of effed in that scenario just because, like, if he dashed in, he could have gotten back aired. If he jumped, he was going to get back aired. Mm-hmm. Like, her back air really messes with you at the ledge like that. But Hungry definitely played it better towards the end. I mean, those lightning kicks were really spot on. That snipe
was
sick.
With the fair off stage.
Yeah.
While he was in disadvantage.
Yeah.
That was the...
Yeah.
What's that Yu-Gi-Oh card?
I'm not good at Yu-Gi-Oh cards.
Not Mirror Shot.
But one of the things about Zelda, too, is that, like, people have to remember that, like, I think people have the idea that this character is horrible. Like, from Smash 4, she was, like, bottom three, maybe even the worst in the game.
Yeah.
And her disadvantage state was horrible. But in this game, her disadvantage state is her moves are all better, and, like, her movement options are better. It's harder to put her in disadvantage. And she has lightning kick from both sides of her. It's not just knee. It's knee on both sides.
Honestly, and lightning kick is ridiculous.
The counter pick, I was kind of going to predict that he would do this. I think that Inklings win this matchup. And a lot of Palutena say that Inklings give them a hard time.
Yeah, because it's the movement.
It's the movement. Like, Palutena's not really gonna just, like, tomahawk in your face. Like, Inklings can just go under and like.
Palutena's
grab
more
him.
Of like a top tier with a zone.
Yeah.
Rather than like if you can hop in and out of that zone, you're definitely plus on the matchup.
Yeah, but Palutena is still like one of the best advantage states in the game, maybe even the best in the game. So Inkling's really bad disadvantage state. Like, they have no offensive option.
What are you doing, Ray?
Oh man, Ray going super deep, man. He's trying to end this, man.
He's a player. Like, if he doesn't see a stop sign on the road, he'll just go.
Yeah. Now the one crucial thing though is that one of the reasons this matchup is so good for Inkling is because the up throw up air works really long on Palutena.
Oh, does it?
But Hungry's not. He's like kind of like oh my goodness, he just flowed into that.
There was no red light there.
Hungry's not like a real Inkling main, and he's not good at doing that combo specifically, but he has a great neutral as a player, and he can get rollers.
Yeah,
so,
we saw it earlier in his set against I don't know who. I completely forget. But I remember, like, the way he spaces his bears just in neutral.
Yeah.
They're so frustrating.
Right. But Ray's doing a great job. I mean, Ray looks very comfortable right now. He doesn't look scared at all, and the roller's going to be hard to get on Palu because she's always jumping.
Boomy!
He tried it.
Oh, yeah, whatever Austi calls it.
He's actually, it's too early to work at. Palutena, it's at 112, it begins. You can only do it earlier than 112 if you have Rage. So Hungry went for it way too early there. Should have went for like an up throw mix up rather than the actual up throw up air.
Right. But again, you said he's not a main.
Yeah. But he does have great wins with Inklings already, so he can definitely do it. But right now it's looking really rough, and Ray looks super comfortable.
Right, still shooting those explosive flames.
Oh man, reading that jump, man, where was he gonna go?
So what Ray did, he convinced him that jumping was the better option. Good up air.
Right.
With all those explosive flames,
right.
Like, I don't want to keep shielding these explosive flames. I'm gonna jump.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna punish that with an up smash because I don't have to hop up there like most characters.
Right.
I just put my up smash out. You're gonna jump right into it.
Oh boy, Ray is trying to murder people today, bro.
I don't know.
He's not trying to play Smash.
He's like on a speed run.
He doesn't want to play the game. He just wants to go home. What I want to see more from Hungry is using the Splat Bomb more. He hasn't used it once so far. Like, Ray is kind of platform camping.
He has used it.
Okay.
I think he got eaten out.
Yeah, I want to see him use it more, especially because like Ray is hanging out on those platforms a lot. Like. You want to force him to not do that. Really smart to recover a high. Free roller.
No one plays this character anymore. He didn't know he couldn't do that.
Oh, boy. This is looking rough for NJ's finest.
All right, you're in New York. I'll clarify.
Oh, that was a great roller, and that's a death.
Up we go.
Yeah. Sweet spot, baby. Palutena, one of the characters that definitely pops out of the first hit of
upstairs. We're going to see some Inkling combos.
This isn't out of his reach if he can get some of the bread and butter stuff down, because their damage output's great right here, getting the free 20% damage multiplier. Let's go. Ray's going to camp that platform until that ink is gone.
Yep.
Oh, but he has him at the ledge. This might be it. You can't jump from the ledge. He's got to pick a dash attack there.
Oh, no. Another
one? And drop down there? No.
Good decision.
Yeah, great decision from Hungry there to use that directional air dodge.
It's like you want to punish it, but you just got to wait for the train to pass by.
Yeah. Man, this Palu just has him at the ledge the entire game, it feels like. The super last hit of Nair.
What percent was he at? Like 160?
Let's find out.
I'm definitely alive.
He was at 143, so that was definitely going to kill him, especially if he was already by the ledge.
I definitely thought he was at like 130.
Yeah, and Ray really smart there because he put him in an impossible scenario where he's like, look, I put the explosive flame there.
Yeah.
So you have to go low now. You're not going to jump over that and get hit by my up air. Or I can just nair you or fairy.
He had already jumped. He already used his jump.
So he was done.